A Pakistani anti-terror court has delayed the verdict of two terror financing cases against 26/11 terror attack mastermind Hafiz Saeed. Acting on Saeed's plea, the Lahore court has delayed the verdict to the 11th of February. The verdict was expected today. Saeed told the court that the verdict of all his cases should be pronounced together. The delay comes as yet another eyewash by Pakistan as the country tries to show the world that it has been taking a stand against terror. Pakistan has arrested Saeed over a dozen times in the past, but it refuses to convict the United Nations designated global terrorist. Remember, Pakistan has arrested Hafiz Saeed 16 times in the past, but every time the mastermind of the 26/11 Mumbai terror attack has walked free. India has provided dossier after dossier on Hafiz Saeed's involvement, but so far Hafiz Saeed has not been convicted. Let's go across live now to WION's Pakistan Bureau Chief Anas Malik, who's joining us live from Lahore for more details on this story. Anas, first of all, tell us the details. It appears that justice has been delayed once again. Now, these were terror financing related cases against Hafiz Saeed, isn't it? But once again, the UN designated global terrorist, he has not been convicted by the Pakistani court.
Absolutely, Shobhit, won't be wrong to say that these are indeed delaying tactics from the globally designated terrorist Hafiz Saeed. Today, the verdict in two of his pending cases, that where trial was already completed, was all set to be announced in the Anti-Terror Court of Lahore by Judge Arshad Hussain Bhutta. But at the 11th hour, just before the court was to be convened, and Hafiz Saeed filed an application through his lawyer, a plea through his lawyers, that the court should take into consideration, and the fact that all of his pending cases should be heard as well. And then after the pending cases are done, then all of those verdicts should be announced together in a clubbed manner. Now, the court has deferred that the announcement of the verdict by till the 11th of February. Now, what is interesting is the fact that there is only one pending case at the ATC Lahore of Hafiz Saeed, that is to do with that has been recently transferred. Just yesterday, it has been transferred from this from the Gujarat Anti-Terror Court to Lahore upon the insistence of Hafiz Saeed that he cannot travel between Lahore and Gujarat every now and then. Therefore, now just on a 24-hour notice, this plea was done on the basis of the transfer that was done just 24 hours earlier. That was very interesting, and that was more of a shocker as well, because the court reporters there too were not aware of the fact that Hafiz Saeed, that there was a case indeed pending against Hafiz Saeed at this very court, at this anti-terror court of Lahore, where we were earlier today. Now, if you talk about security arrangement, there were a lot of security arrangements that were in place. About 50 special policemen from the anti-terror and anti-riot force were deployed there. And towards the end of it, when this plea was filed, the prosecutor general or the prosecution the prosecutor for the government, Abdul Rauf Fatu, he argued that since the trial in the previous two cases have been completed, therefore the court should take into consideration and should announce the verdict of these two cases at the earliest. Now, the matter has been deferred until the 11th of February. It is still unclear whether on the 11th of February the court would be hearing or considering Hafiz Saeed's plea to hear the pending cases, one, or would it be going ahead with the government, the government's stance and the government's plea that it should be announcing the verdict. So, all ends on the anti-terror court in Lahore on what it comes up with the what happens on the 11th of February. Yes, Shobhit.
Absolutely, Anas. You know, the victims and their families of the 26/11 terror attack are still awaiting justice. How much proof does Pakistan need? The United Nations has designated Hafiz Saeed as a global terrorist. He's the head of JUD as well. But tell us, what does it mean for Pakistan? Because Pakistan is already in the grey list of the FATF, isn't it? The anti-terror financing watchdog. How does this impact Pakistan's effort to get out of that grey list?
Well, it would be a major shocker if at all Hafiz Saeed is not convicted, or if he gets to walk free. from this court, because Pakistan has been claiming, remember, that it has been cracking down hard on terror financing and those people and individual who are linked to it. Now, remember, this particular Hafiz Saeed and his organization Jamaat-ud-Dawah was among those seven organizations that were named by the FATF in its public press release after the plenary meeting that took place in February 2019. So if at all he is convicted, then Pakistan would have a moral standing or a moral ground to boast about the fact that it is indeed robustly acting, and something that is to do with practical action rather than showing it on mere words or in paper. So it would have definitely been a major moral booster or given a major moral ground to the Pakistani side to boast about it. But for now, with this verdict being delayed, or this possible conviction being delayed, things would not be easy in the plenary meeting that is to take place starting the 16th of February, that is just next Sunday. Things would not be that easy for the Pakistani delegation. Yes, Shobhit.
Anas, thank you so much for getting us all the details. Remember, Hafiz Saeed is not only the head of the JUD, but also the founder of terror group LET as well. All eyes will be on the Pakistani court on the 11th, where the victims and families would await the verdict of the Pakistani court against Hafiz Saeed.